confused everyone.
All right. Let's go ahead and grab into this first one. Grounded in Pentiment are Microsoft's first Xbox exclusive games for Nintendo Switch. That's right, so those games are finally, they're finally happening. Grounded and Pentiment are the first previously Xbox exclusive games to arrive on Nintendo Switch. Obsidian's 2D narrative adventure role-playing game Pentiment will launch on Switch tomorrow, followed by Grounded, the survival co-op that that's a combination of Honey, I Shrunk the Kids and A Bug's Life. And that one will be on April 16th. Oh, that's going to be super cool. Pacific Drive is out. I think it just dropped. Was it today, Cyclo? Was it today or was it yesterday? It had to be today. I'm pretty sure games come out on Thursdays now. Called it. I was excited to see. I saw a little gameplay thing the other day, and I was like, it looks good though. Both games were confirmed in Nintendo's partner showcase today after Microsoft revealed last week that it would be taking four previously Xbox exclusive games to rival consoles like the PS5 and at Nintendo. The Verge revealed that the four games would be Hi-Fi Rush, Pentiment, Sea of Thieves, and Grounded. Hi-Fi Rush was rumored for Nintendo Switch. It's not clear if the game is still launching on the Switch though. A recent data mine suggests it could be launching on both PS5 and Nintendo Switch. Hi-Fi Rush was a surprise shadow drop last year. After Microsoft's first Xbox developer direct stream, the colorful animated world includes a rhythm action focus where you hit strings in time with the music. So, I saw this one. I think some of these were in here from our good friend Tidal. Should make sure. I always like to make sure I give to do to the do's. Oh, right. Yeah, title through. This one and the next one in, I believe. So we'll go ahead and check. So they're kind of talking about those two games, and then it looked like they found that there was reporting about the other two. Hi-Fi Rush and Sea of Thieves coming to PS5. Which is pretty cool. Bethesda is confirming today that Hi-Fi Rush is coming to PS5 on March 19th. The reveal initially came in a video from Bethesda Latam before Microsoft confirmed that Hi-Fi Rush and Sea of Thieves are both arriving on PS5. Sea of Thieves will be arriving on PS5 on April 30th. Oh, damn. That's a little bit of ways away still. But I'll be excited. I don't know if I'll pick Sea of Thieves up again. I guess it depends on what the price is. So all the games are coming to PlayStation, and then only Pentiment and Grounded right now are coming to Switch. Oh, that's kind of crazy. Well, that's kind of real crazy. Yeah, I need to jump back into Sea of Thieves again sometime here, especially now that they got their solo mode going. Well, they're offline mode, I guess. Interesting. Yeah, it's pretty crazy that they that's kind of what they're doing. I mean, this is a good strategy by Microsoft, though. At least I think so. We'll see. I don't know. But yeah, I think it's cool. At least PS5 is getting all of them, because I think Grounded would be a cool one to pick up. Sea of Thieves would be good on PS5. I don't know anything about Pentiment, and I know very little about Hi-Fi Rush, but I think Hi-Fi Rush would be a good one too. It feels like they're all pretty good games, you know, at least for the most part that they're bringing over. So at least it's good games. Cool. Let's jump into this next one. This is a trailer for a game called Arranger. I didn't see anything about this one, but it was thrown in here by Cyclo. When was this? Oh, a day ago, huh? So I don't know anything about this. I didn't watch it ahead of time because I wanted to, you know, get the pure reactions here. But yeah, let's take a look at this trailer.
Gemma is a curious girl who moves through the world in her own special way.
Oh my God, it's slide puzzles.
She grew up in a cozy, tucked away town. But she never really fit in. So she's taking a journey to the land beyond. Where for the first time ever, she doesn't know what's around the corner.
That's pretty interesting.
But she's unlocking its mysteries. Even when the way forward isn't always what you expect. And exploring the unknown may be the key to finding out who she really is and where she belongs.
Whoa, all right. All right, that looks pretty interesting. Damn, man, that looks, yeah, that actually looks really good, though. I'm not mad about it at all. Yeah, like I said, kind of looks just all like, everything's like slide puzzles, which is pretty cool. Kind of an interesting take. Not something I've ever felt like I've seen before. But, I mean, looks like it could be really fun. Not sure I'd be any good at that one. Yeah, maybe not, man. I mean, slide puzzles are one of those things, like, either you're good at them or you're not. But I fucking love it. I love a slide puzzle. That's one of my one things I think I'm actually okay at. Pendiment is good. Gotta finish it. Nice, man. Okay. So, yeah. So then they are just bringing four pretty decent games over to the other consoles. That's awesome. Chinese slide puzzles. Oh, okay. I don't know about those ones, man. I don't even know how you say that word. Harong? I'm saying it very much how it's spelled, so it could be super wrong. I'm so sorry. Yeah, but this looks awesome, man. I appreciate you dropping that because I didn't even see this at all. Wasn't even in the you know, bunch of stuff that I saw over this week. Excuse me. He had to give up on. Oh, interesting. That's crazy, man. I don't know why I really like them. I would like to do more of them, but it seems like solitaire and slide puzzles. That's what I'm pretty good at. Solitaire, your boy's pretty good, actually. Also, speaking of puzzles. This is not one of the topics, but I think it's Soika game. Or it's said some other way. I don't know. That game is got a weird name. It's the fruit game. If you guys haven't seen it, there's one that there's a game that's specifically on Switch. I think there's a website version as well. But the Switch version is getting some DLC where you can play multiplayer. And me and Emily both like that game a lot, so I was like, "Ooh, this is gonna be great. We'll have to get this." Yeah, so I was pretty hyped about that. I didn't think it was worth putting into the actual news, but I figured, you know, might as well say it. Made into the mainstream. Hey, that's pretty cool, though. I love me some solitaire, bro. Listen, I'm out here kicking ass in solitaire, bro. That's all I do. Every time I think about it and I boot it up, asses are getting kicked. It ain't even a question. Oh, dang it. I feel like I have like a something in my throat all day. after the update. Oh, yeah, that's right. We talked about this one of the last times I talked about Solitaire. I think I had said something about it the last time, and then you were like, oh yeah, I left that on my phone. I was like, oh damn, bro. Yeah, when we were, Emily and I were, we were road tripping somewhere. Oh, we were moving her sister somewhere. I specifically should make sure there's no sound on this. Oh, come on. You got to sign me in. Yeah, come on. Yeah, I specifically like downloaded like Microsoft Solitaire because that's where I was doing all my work at. Yeah, I mean, listen, even just classic Solitaire, only a level 14, but 14, not that bad, you know? I'll be out there kicking ass, all right? Don't think there's anything different, all right? We did. I knew we did, man. I had a feeling. All right, so let's get into this next one. This is like, you know, not technically rumors, and I don't like necessarily going about rumors, but I thought this could be really interesting. Mr. Solitaire Dolo. Damn, bro. You really getting me with it. You really hit me with those things I like to hear. Rogue One director Gareth Edwards is in talks to direct the new Jurassic World movie. Listen, Gareth Edwards is actually pretty phenomenal when it comes to being a director. And as soon as I was like, ooh, in talks? That could be very interesting, very spicy indeed. I would be very much into that. Some of those last couple of Jurassic World movies were not that good. You know, listen, I'm just gonna call a spade here. And so, yeah, I understand, man. But like, I like the Jurassic Park 1 and 2 a lot. And then Jurassic 4 was pretty good. So 3 and 5, 6 are bad. They're not good. I don't know if I would say they're bad. They're fine. But, you know, it'd be nice to see what Gareth Edwards would be able to do. I think he's just a good director. So I think he could bring some vision to it. So, yeah, he did Rogue One, which I think was easily the best Star Wars, the new Star Wars movies. He also did The Creator, which is on Hulu. That movie is really pretty good, but also very beautiful. His movies are just beautiful, and they have a look about them that are really good. Stopped at one book. Yes, that's what authors normally do, is they usually write one book and then they stop. So I thought this was interesting, you know. I'm not gonna go into the story because there's not much in there. I just sometimes I like having these up just so that I can talk about them. Nintendo Switch Online is getting some more rare classic games as of I think yesterday. I saw this and I was like, ooh, I like seeing what rare games are gonna be on Nintendo. So they're getting Killer Instinct, which is sick. I wish I could just put it up there right now so y'all could get a little combo breaker. Battletoads and Battle Maniac. I don't know what that is. It doesn't sound like the actual Battletoads game. Maybe it is, I don't know. RC Pro-Am and Snake Rattle and Roll, which some of these I don't really know. Combo breaker. Yeah, see? That's what I want. So yeah, I was like, okay, cool. I want to talk about these as a, just a thing to show off. But then they were talking about Donkey Kong 64. No word on that coming to Nintendo Switch Online, which is sad. Donkey Kong 64. Combo breaker. Okay. Not that one, bro. Come on. Come on. How dare you? How effing dare you? Sorry, my top of my monitor was all dusty. Lights are really killing it today. But yeah, I was glad because Cyclo and I were kind of talking about Banjo-Kazooie. Yeah, recently, and I specifically went on and looked to make sure that they had it on the Nintendo Switch Online stuff, and they totally do, and I am happy about that. All right, let's get into this next one. Monster Hunter Stories Remaster is coming to Switch. That's right. Oh, they do. Nice. Yeah, bro, they totally do. Former 3DS exclusive Monster Hunter Stories is coming to Nintendo Switch in the summer of 2024. Announced during Nintendo Direct Partner Showcase on February 21st, the remaster of Monster Hunter Stories arrives with full voice acting for the first time and HD visuals. An in-game museum has also been added for players to peruse artwork and listen to the game's soundtrack. I was trying to see if they had announced a price. Was Monster Hunter Stories ever cost money? I don't know. I felt like I had it, but I got it on my, I think I had it on my phone, which is even more weird. So this is like the first time where I was like, okay, maybe I would check out Monster Hunter Stories. If it's free, you better believe it. You better believe I'll be over there. I had it for 3DS or something. All right. I love a good or something. But yeah, you're right. I mean, I think that's what they were saying. It was mostly a 3DS game, but I thought I got it on mobile at some point though. But yeah, it's not great. You know, it's not great, but it's fine. It was on mobile. Yeah, I was going to say, I thought that's where I played it. Because I don't think I got it on my 3DS. Did it ever cost money, though? That's what I was kind of wondering, though. I was going to see if I may probably still have it, so it probably isn't going to actually show up. Maybe it will. I don't know. Physical copy. That seems like a bad choice. No, I still own it, so it says install. It doesn't give me any other information. But they have this really nice little trailer that plays in the Google Play Store for it. Yo, Casper, what's happening? What it do? What it means? What is it? What's happening, Casper? How you doing, man? Yeah, physical copy of it, man. Really interesting. I didn't feel like that game was worth having a physical copy of. Got him. No, it was fine. I think I played like an hour and I was like, I don't think this is for me. But maybe some voice acting and stuff and, you know, a little remaster wouldn't be a bad thing to do, you know? All right. Also, Epic Mickey is getting a Nintendo Switch remake. I don't know shit about Epic Mickey, but I remember hearing about this game when it very first was coming out. Disney's Epic Mickey is getting a remake for Nintendo Switch later this year called Epic Mickey Rebrushed. Announced during the Nintendo Switch. All right. Yeah. No release date beyond a vague 2024 was given for the game, but a faithful remake of the beloved classic was promised. I love a good promised. Dropped a photo of it in the Discord. Ooh. Let me use my eyes to look at it. Ooh. Damn.
I like that leather background you have there, man. It's a really nice setting.
I assume it's vegan leather, though. Let's, come on, man. Yo, show, what's happening? Guys, I've had no internet for about 3 days. Holy shit. Holy shit. Well, yeah. Data to pop in and say, I appreciate it. Don't overuse the datas, show. We see you. We love you. Get the fuck out of here. Oh my God, that sucks. I'm okay just looking funny. Hey, that picture wasn't that funny, man. I mean, it looks pretty tough, actually, my dude. I'm just gonna say it. Look pretty tough. Leather? I'm not vegan, what you mean? I wear wool and leather and Uggs. Oh my God, this mother. Damn. This dude just out here ready to just slaughter some animals just for the fun of it. Not even for the pieces, you know? Bro's a straight up a Cruella de Vil out here. Yeah, in the Discord. That's what I'm saying, man. It was, I can say, a good picture, though. About to run out, and someone is going to die tomorrow over it, I swear. Hey, you stay awesome. We'll catch up soon, though, whenever you get some internet again. Yeah, thanks so much, show. Damn, I can't believe this. This dude just out here. Man, it's just out here. He really getting everybody thinking that he's some kind of this or that, and then. Barely played stories. Yeah, that's how I was too, man. It was, like I said, I just thought it was okay. Also, this is some benign. This is off of, I believe, his new track. Or his, yeah, his new. This is a new track off his new album. Yeah, that is. This is the first time I'm getting to hear it, so. I love the piano in it. It's very nice. All right, let's go on to the next. We actually, damn, we out here speed running the news today. And I'm okay with it. You got some good ones on the new album? I have not checked it out yet. This is the first time I'm getting to hear anything. Yeah, when the internet is down, it is a pain. To do anything that you want to do is just like everything you realize is like, fuck, it's all connected to the internet now. So be strong out there, y'all. Be strong. Avengers: The Kang Dynasty is reportedly getting a new title. Uh-oh. He sent me a link because he sampled Bebop in a song. Yeah, he sent me a link the other day too. I think you were saying something about this the other day. Did I mention that he sent me a link because he has some Bioshock samples that he was doing, not on, I don't think on this album, but on some other songs, I think. Oh, shoot. Oh. So yeah, I meant to get around to listening to those. I haven't yet. Ooh, nice. Yeah, on older songs. That's cool. I think so, yeah. As you guys probably know, recently, Jonathan Majors and Disney/Marvel have kind of split up. And because of that, it sounds like Marvel/Disney is going to be kind of moving in a different direction with, like, not using Kang as like their big bad anymore. And so they are looking to probably change the title to be less Kang centric. A lot of people think that they're still going to use Kang at some point. I forget who they were saying. There's another guy that they were talking about. I can't remember the guy's name though. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Coleman Domingo was who they were talking about. Maybe, I think he was in some talks about recasting for Kang. I haven't seen much of him in anything too much, but what I have seen, pretty good. So I'd be all right. Yeah. Yep. Exactly, Casper. So they are reportedly right now going to be giving that Avengers a new title, and you know, I'll be interested to see what that ends up being. Man, this has really caused them some headaches. Yeah, I mean, they're always going to use Doctor Doom. It just depended on when they were going to do it. They were definitely building towards that being a bigger thing, as like they're going to jump into Secret Wars as the Avengers movie after this one. And Secret Wars is very specifically like a Doctor Doom thing. So big sad. Yeah, it is. That is why. I mean, that's not the only reason. It's why you shouldn't be a douche. I know, it's crazy. But that's why you shouldn't. At least one of the reasons. Because it can affect the rest of your fucking life. Alright. Alright. So if you guys didn't know, we did talk about it very, very quickly on Tuesday. That Elden Ring is getting some DLC. And they finally showed off the official trailer for it. Don't be a douche. Hey, that's what I'm about. That's a quote I would put on a shirt. But yeah, so they finally showed off the trailer. I figured we'd watch it here. I'm gonna go ahead and say I watched it. I've seen a lot of Elden Ring. I think I've seen almost all of Elden Ring, and I have no idea what the fuck this is about. I'm sure people get it. Elden Ring's one of those games. Just like what Limbo was playing, Alan Wake 2 and Control. I feel like Elden Ring is exactly like that for me. Like I enjoy watching those things, but I have no idea what the fuck's happening. I don't get what the story is. I don't know. But this is this will be the trailer for that. Let's have a look.
Pure and radiant, he wields love to shrive clean the hearts of men. There is nothing more terrifying. In that forsaken place, blood must spill. Blood of your fellows. They are truly faithful.
They were never saints. They just happened to be on the losing side of a war.
Mother, wouldst thou truly lordship sanction in one so bereft of life? too are keen to know just what kind Mikomer is doing here.
Those stripped of the grace of gold shall all meet death in the embrace of Vesna's flame.
Come now, touch the withered arm and travel to the realm of shadow. I will not be far behind. May we meet again.
I'm gonna go ahead and say it. I mean, it looks pretty good though, right? You know, it looked pretty good. I mean, it's just hard. It's hard for me to understand what the hell is going on, but it looks pretty good. A lot going on. I agree with that, but it looks great. There's a couple of like things specifically. I think it was right around in here somewhere where they started to show off like some of this stuff. This all kind of looked like new combat stuff. I can't tell though, maybe it's not, but they were doing like these like intense kicks and shit that was fucking those things. Goddamn, I love that. I don't know if that's just an enemy that does it though. It's I can't tell. I don't know what these are. Are these players? Is this what's happening? It's so hard to know what's going on. But like I said, I think it looks pretty cool. There was a dude in here specifically I wanted to point out. This guy fucking this one is the one of the weird ones that kind of was like getting me a little bit. So he's like stabbed straight down. You can see into like where his chest is like open and everything. You can see that like thorns are like straight down and they're like poking out of his side and stuff, and the bro is trying to pull this thing out. Oh my god. Ooh. Yeah, that's a tough one for me. Great enemy design. Yeah, and sometimes better than others. I felt like Elden Ring's enemy design is top tier. Bloodborne is really up there for me as well. The other ones I don't always love quite as much. But yeah, I really like Elden Rings a lot, and I mean, this looks like it's gonna be bringing some very cool enemies to the game. So, all right, let's go ahead and jump into this next one. This one I'm not super excited about it, but I felt like I should probably show it off. So apparently there's gonna be I think it's a Borderlands movie. I don't know. I think it's a Borderlands movie. And so there's a trailer for it. I just seen this trailer. Yeah, well, prepare to see it again. I'm not gonna give you guys any forewarning about anything. Just go ahead and just watch it. Use your eyes and watch it. Use your ears and hear it. Just do all those things.
Would you look at that? A ladder! Unfortunately, my design doesn't facilitate this type of...
Well, destiny awaits.
Legend has it that there's this massive treasure hidden in some secret vault. And if you go hunting for it, you'd better take any help you can get. Because it's on the weirdest, most dangerous dumpster fire of a world in the universe.
God, I hate this planet.
What is that smell?
Piss Wash Gully.
Ew!
Put the window up.
I don't want to.
Roll the window up. Rolling up.
It's Pete. It's Pete. Why do you think it's called Piss Wash? How did it get the name?
It's in my mouth.
Do you know how many people have died looking for this vault?
We have something they don't, baby girl.
Okay.
What?
Major issues.
Time to make it rain with your body parts.
What did I tell you?
Minimal no explosions.
I said no explosions. Do you want my love?
Mine's bigger.
What are you doing?
I needed a gun.
So you asked for it.
There's only one of you in the world, and you're special.
Uh-oh.
Kill them all. What's happening right now?
I'm expelling the excess lead. I can't go if you're looking at me. Actually, scrap that. I can. I really can. Actually, it's helping.
Are we really waiting for this to finish?
Keep looking at me.
Yeah, I don't understand this one. Yo, Tidal, what's happening, buddy? Kate Blanchett was a weird pick. You know what this gives vibes to me? They were like, ooh, you guys ever seen Guardians of the Galaxy? Let's do that as Borderlands. Oh my God. It's just weird though. Another one that looks like cosplay. It does really, really look like cosplay. Like they don't know how to just kind of do things in a way that's like, slightly more subtle. They could make it be like a little more like, oh, okay. But maybe it's kind of going for that look. No hints of great dialogue. Agreed. It looks like a crazy film, but it doesn't interest me. Yeah, right. Yeah, and that's kind of how I don't know. It just does not look good to me. And as a person who doesn't play Borderlands, I have no idea how closely this is going to follow any like Borderlands stories or anything. But it very much just felt like, oh, they were very much just going for like, which is as long as it's like Guardians of the Galaxy, people will watch it. Yeah, her hair definitely looks wild. I don't know. I just think it's bad in general, though. All of it just was not probably a good idea. So I figured I should show this, even if it's bad. I shouldn't just choose things that are good or things that I care about. I should try and bring things that are, you know, kind of bad sometimes too. Have that Guardians vibe. Yeah, like a bunch of people who are like, oh, we don't really like each other. Oh, but now we really like each other. You know? Oh man, and then they had the fucking Guardians of the Galaxy tunes and stuff over top of it. Brandy Pitchfork? Pitchford? Who is that, who's working on it? So wait, how is he involved with it?
You have reached your destination. Welcome.
Because he's the former CEO of Gearbox. Yeah, I don't know, man. I can't get behind this, but you know, listen, if it looks interesting to you, great. I mean, everybody's tastes are different, you know. And so if you end up liking it, that's great. I saw this and it made me eye roll pretty hard. So games and everything, yeah, that's kind of what I saw. They said former CEO, and then they were like, and he may have teased the next game. Like, why would he be teasing anything from them? That doesn't make any sense. I also saw this. This will be a quick one, just a jump and hit. So The Boys season 4 is getting a release date of June 13th 2024. I haven't ever watched any of The Boys, but if it's a show that you like, rejoice as season 4 will be back, you know, in June. I do need to get around to watching them at some point, but maybe it'll be worth waiting until season 4 is out and then going through it all. All right, two more real quick. This one is a legit pretty interesting one. One I had not thought about. Season 1 was good. Oh yeah, have you not watched anything else? So you guys all remember Bionicles, and if you don't, that's okay. That one's okay. It's okay if you guys don't remember Bionicles. If it was something else, you know, some kind of rodent, maybe that they rode like a two-wheeled vehicle and they were not from Earth, that one I might be upset about. But I remember, but never had Bionicles. Oh damn, bro, I totally had a single Bionicle, and it was for a little bit, and yeah, it didn't really last. It wasn't really for me. Patridge Farm remembers. Title, were you here the other day when we talked about the biker mice from Mars? So, the point I bring that up is apparently there is a 14 carat Lego piece that is selling for more than $18,000 at Goodwill auction. Look at this. It's a fucking Bionicle piece. Apparently this motherfucker is $18,000 worth of gold. Yes. Oh shit, never mind then. Don't. Damn, I was hoping you were gonna be there with me for a minute, man. I was hoping. I was like, oh, maybe he wasn't here. Damn. Yeah, apparently found in a Pennsylvania Goodwill. This person just fucking found this and they were like, yeah, I'll pick that up. And they were like, oh, that'll be $18,000. That's not how it was when they first got it. And a 14 karat gold Lego piece sold for $18,101 at Goodwill online auction house on Wednesday. Oh, okay. So it was on their auction house. Never mind. The Lego piece is the golden Kanhai Hua mask from Lego's Bionicle line, which was produced in 2000. Of course, this is no ordinary Lego piece. The company produced a bunch of plastic versions of the various Bionicle masks, but only a couple dozen of the golden pieces, which were reportedly given away during special Lego promotions. Lego held several competitions over the years with gold Bionicle masks as prizes. One prize asked kids to build websites, while another was a sweepstakes with Cartoon Network. It's not clear how many solid gold masks were given away, but Goodwill Industries of North Central Pennsylvania Vice President of E-Commerce and Technology estimated to CBS that the number was around 25. Jesus Christ. So, if you guys ever see a gold Bionicle mask, you better get in. If you can get it for less than $18,000, you're getting a steal, because you know you can flip it for at least that. Imagine having that kind of money to burn. I couldn't imagine. I can't imagine that kind of stuff. That seems so outside the realm of real life. I was trying to see. I tried to look up Bionicles too, just to try to go down memory lane here a second, but pay off student debts, give money to those. Yeah, I agree. That's kind of how I always felt about having an excess of money is, A, you know, of course, take care of myself. But then B, I enjoy kind of, you know, being able to do those things where you can kind of give away, you know, a little bit. It's a good time, so. Nah, you buy them Legos. I don't think so. All right, last one is, so it is Thursday. That means, why not both? That means Epic Store, the Epic Game Store, has a free game. And actually, pretty crazily, it is Super Meat Boy Forever. So, I mean, obviously, most people who know, you know, Super Meat Boy, but I always get a trailer, so we should get it. We should watch the trailer and Gold Joel Lego. Oh gosh. So yeah, let's go ahead and take a look at this trailer for Super Meat Boy Forever, which is the free game over on Epic Game Store this week. Holy shit. Listen, I did not watch this ahead of time. I probably should have. Good Christ. So yeah, if you want to pick that up, it is free over on the Epic Game Store. It's definitely one of those ones that's definitely worth it. They're fantastic games, so. Wouldn't have to be gold for me to buy it. Samesies. I'd get some Joel Legos. Little doc about Super Meat Boy was so heartfelt and sweet. Wasn't it about a bunch of indie games though? Wasn't that one? Is that one you were talking about? Because I thought that was the one I saw Fez with, and it was like, it was one of those ones where you were like, ooh, this guy's kind of a douche. The guy who made Fez. Yeah, it was an indie doc. Yeah, that I remember that one. It was really good. Oh yeah, it was called Indie Game the Movie. That's right. Yeah, that movie was, or that thing, crazy. Fez, not so much. What about Fez? Because I thought Fez as a game was really good. I'm pretty sure. Being really frustrated. Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought I remember hearing really good things about Fez. I just know the guy who made Fez, his name is Phil Fish. He's just a little bit all over the place, and he really, I don't know, he's really up and down. I don't know. So yeah, so that is, I think that's it for the news. Actually, pretty crazy. We fucking speed ran the news today. So yeah, we'll go ahead and, yeah, I think you said that'll be it for the news. We'll hang out a little bit before we get into some Bound, but, yeah, thank you all so much for coming out.